Hold on. Let's see something quick here. Born in your. Okay, I'm gonna reset everything. Create a new character. Call him me. Me1Z. Oh. Somebody has my name already. That's why. I don't know. The hell? What kind of all white character is this? Needs to be 1 hour old. But you made me into a white guy. This fucking game. Oh my God, I can't believe this. Oh. Okay, never mind. Never mind, I guess I was just tripping. I'm bad if that's not a tool. Wait. What the hell was that? Soft locked. How do I grab this map? Hang on for a sec. Thank you. chop those things too? No. Why can't I equip this? Requires level 4. Oh. I see how it is, game. I'm trying to figure out how to make ore. Like, you know how to forge like an iron piece or some shit? Because the crafting bench doesn't make ore. Oh, here we are.
staff has to save some time, but you have to buy these. And we'll look at the shop in depth later. While building my character, the music also has so and really liked it when the game did that. So far, lots of small issues. I'll note this down and come back to it later. So, building a character goes overall style, class within that style, path within that class, and one of the game's greatest strengths and its greatest weaknesses is just how many builds are possible and viable. And the best thing about the strengths of any build is they're normally situational and can excel when in a team. A cleric can indeed heal wounds, but they aren't just a heal stick, because heal wounds also hurts undead creatures. Rogues are stealthy, but they're also the only class that can find secret passages and pick locks, so you want to take one with you. And if you don't like to build, there's a reincarnation system where you reset to level 1, rebuild, and go again, keeping some benefits from your past life.
Wow.
So Dungeons & Dragons Online can be played entirely solo. Teaming up is the best way to balance the weaknesses of your build, and your build doesn't have to be permanent. So we'll look at the reincarnation system later. In another lovely touch, each class has a solo viability tech. Now, I can't find the seduced bartender skill in the bard list, so plan A is out the window. On to plan B. A dragonborn truth-bringer paladin, and we start the game locked up on a beach after a shipwreck. Just like Neverwinter Online. And now we're online. You know, I assume the role in any RPG world would be something like Dragon Hunter or being a level 1 bandit, but apparently it's Sailor. I guess in Fantasyland, you either die a quaint forest village start or live long enough to wash up on the beach stuff. Game starts. WASD movement, spaces jump, and the narration audio immediately overlaps with the talking NPC. You can just lean closer and squint. I tried to find the upscale UI slider, but the only scale slider is for the text above NPCs and objects' heads. You cannot change the scale of this UI. Please make that possible, because it is tiny. But it's okay, because the D&DO wiki does have a solution to increase the scale of the UI. Simply decrease the resolution of the rest of the game. I wish I was joking. Thankfully, the keys are super easy to rebind and the map is serviceable, so with our new sword equipped, we bravely dispatch some dangerous barrels, and then my urge to leap to my death is stifled by this massive invisible wall. We're told to talk to Selenus and sent into this cave, and this is a dungeon, so we get the dungeon menu. Choose your difficulty, solo, easy, medium, hard, or Reaper, and each dungeon has these options, and you unlock harder modes by completing the previous, meaning you can just grind dungeons. We get an anti-death spell cast on us, which is really in-universe. Doesn't die during the tutorial, but also leaves me questioning, if an anti-death spell exists, why isn't it the first and only spell anyone ever learns? The fall damage is quite substantial, and hold left click to swing your sword wildly. Our party then gets ambushed, and thankfully the AI can hold their own. So behold, combat.
Well, I already had a rod. What the hell?
connection to the 3.5 edition ruleset, which itself is a revised version of the 5th edition ruleset. D&D players will know that 3.5 offered an immense amount of customization and freedom over character.
Thank you.
Forward or back. backwards onto the sides, and this will matter later when the projectiles start flying. We light up the back behind